Get ready to match the stars. Scoey Mitchell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Susan Sullivan, Richard Dawson, and Betty White. As we play the star-studded big money match game 77. And now here's the star of match game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Everybody home? My friends? How tired. Everybody ready?
Yeah.
Shall we have a go at it?
Why not?
Would you all briskly applause Julie Yeager and...
Applause.
Give a brisk round of applause.
Would you all briskly applause?
Yes. Very good.
Applaud.
As I introduce Julie Yeager and Evanette Edwards.
No.
Now. Now, Julie is our current champion. She's won $11,200, and that puts a big smile on her face, as you can plainly see. Yeah. And now she's going to be challenged by a lady we're meeting for the first time. Evanette, we welcome you.
It's Evanette.
Oh, it's Evanette.
Right.
Evanette, yes, Evanette, I say Evanette. Evanette, that's a very pretty name. Where are you from?
I'm from San Diego. I'm married. I have two children. I have a master's in social work. I'm an aspiring psychiatric social worker sooner or later.
Is there a lot of call for those? I would think it would be, you know, the world is just going crazy. I would think it'd be easy for you to get a job.
Oh, I have a job.
Oh, you have a job?
I'm just working at it.
I see. All right. Well, I hope you win some money here. Good luck to both of you. We'll begin this game in a moment or so, but first we want to do a little business with you. Here we go. Round one coming up. And now, Evanette, you may have A or B.
I'll take A.
You want A?
A.
You sure? You're
right. No, but
A.
That's what
I'll
take.
Even at one's A. Rip Van Winkle said to his wife,
some wife you are. I sleep 20 years, and when I finally wake up, you say blank.
Some wife you are. I sleep 20 years, and when I finally wake up, you say...
Don't look at my answer, Charles.
All right.
Okay,
here we go. Even at Edwards.
I don't want you.
Rip Van Winkle said to his wife, some wife you are. I sleep 20 years, and when I finally wake up, you say...
Not now.
Got a master's degree, eh?
In something.
Dear me. I'm...
Got a master's degree in what?
That's what they teach them today. What'd you say?
I thought I was pretty cute, but hers is really nice. They said, you look tired.
I sleep 20 years. When I finally wake up, you say you look tired. Okay. It's one.
If this isn't a match, I'm going to be extremely cranky. She said, I've got a headache. Isn't that the same thing?
Well, you see, now here's a problem.
It is at our house.
It is at your house.
You're getting so trashy, you're not worth living with.
No, the thing is, I've got a headache means, you know...
Means not now!
All over the world.
No, it does in a way, but it
I've got a headache,
yeah. Well, I'm sorry we can't match those two because the ideas are the same, but the words are different, and we just got to be a little more specific. What do you say, Susan?
Well, this is not even nice.
Oh.
Drop dead.
Drop dead. Okay.
They all mean the same thing.
That's right. Rip Van Winkle said... Some wife you are. I sleep 20 years, and when I finally wake up, you say...
What's new?
Having a lot of laughs, even that,
right.
Not getting many matches over here. Let's see what you got there.
If you think that was trashy,
Take out the garbage.
Take out the garbage. Okay, had some nifty answers there, but not one match. Julie, this one is yours. At Stanley's Soup Kitchen, every bowl of soup has the personal touch because Stanley soaks his blank in the pot.
I hate the question, too. Can I see it again?
I don't even want to read it again.
At Stanley's Soup Kitchen, every bowl of soup has the same because Sammy soaks his
blank in the pot.
No.
Did you hear that?
Sure.
Okay. At Stanley's Soup Kitchen, every bowl of soup has the personal touch because Stanley soaks his blank in the pot.
His feet.
Feet. She said it soaks his feet in the pot.
And if you hadn't have rushed me, I'd have come up with that.
Yeah. Any day now.
I said he soaks his other pots in the pot.
He soaks his other pots in the pot. And what do you say?
I said he soaks his cleaning rag.
Yes, Charles.
I'm nearer than the other experts. Yes. I said he soaks his socks, okay. And his best, too.
And what?
And his best and most popular cellar soup is the one he makes from chicken sock.
Oh, I see. Chicken socks. Susan.
It's the last one.
Stanley soaks his blank in the pot. What do you say?
Well, Scorf, we did it again. Feet.
Oh,
one for Julie.
I don't like to see naked feet on television, so I have some socks to put on.
Okay. A lot of socks and only one pair of feet so far, Betty.
Socks.
Socks. Okay. So there we are, 1-0 at the end of round one. Round two coming up after this for you. Here we go. Round two coming up. Ready? Now, Yvonette, A or B?
I'll stick with A.
You want A again?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's yours. Everybody plays. The parole officer said to the ex-con, he says, Rocco, are you keeping your nose clean? And Rocco said, sure, I blank it every day. Parole officer said to the ex-con, Rocco, you keeping your nose clean? He says, sure, I blank it every day.
Very good.
Now, the parole officer said to the ex-con, Rocco, are you keeping your nose clean? And Rocco said, sure. I blank it every day.
Wash it.
I think you missed the point of this one.
I think
parole officer, it's a figure of speech. Are you keeping your nose clean? And he said, sure, I blow it.
Blow it every day.
Oh. Brett?
Sweetness. Blow.
Oh. Charles?
Blow.
Blow seems to be the answer.
I didn't catch it.
All right. Here we go.
The old blow.
Blow it every day. Are you keeping your nose clean? And Rocco said, sure, I blow it every day. She said, I wash it every day.
No, I wipe it.
You wipe it every day. You must match Betty to stay in the game. Betty?
Wipe.
Wipe. So that means Julie wins the game.
Life.
Well, Yvonette, it was a pleasure to meet you.
It was a pleasure being here, and I really enjoyed myself.
Good luck to you in your career as a psychological social worker. I think that's a wonderful thing to do. Goodbye, Yvonette. Now, you picked up another $100. You got $11,300. You could win you could go get close to $20,000 here if you really do it all the way, Julie. Let's find out what happens. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we got their best response to this. Blank. Tears. T-E-A-R-S. Remember, it's $500 for you if you match the answer they gave most often. $250 for matching their second most popular answer, then $100 for the third. And let's see what kind of answers we'll get from our celebrities.
Okay, Susan.
Blood, sweat, and tears.
Blood, sweat, and tears.
Good. Scoey.
Salty tears.
Salty tears.
Richard.
Crocodile tears.
Crocodile tears. So those are the three. Blood,
you get
sweat,
those
and tears.
By punching a crocodile, by the way, on the nose.
On the nose.
It's the only way you can get them.
And then they cry.
Yeah.
Because they don't like that. Right.
You only do it once, by the way.
That's the a other, croc.
That's a croc, she says. You want one of those, or have you got one of your own?
I don't know. They're all so good.
Salty tears, blood, sweat, and tears, crocodile tears. Any thoughts in your own head if, you know, those are unacceptable to you?
I'm going to go with my Scorpio friend, blood, sweat, and tears.
Blood, sweat, and tears. Okay. Let's find out if we got blood, sweat, and tears up there. May we see the $100 number? No more tears. Uh-huh. Okay, let's see if we've got blood, sweat, and tears under the $250 number.
Baby. Oh, Charles laughed at me because I had baby tears.
Oh. That's
it's
not a
wonderful
a bad answer.
Plan.
Yes, that's right. Indeed it is. Okay, last chance for blood, sweat, and tears. Is it going to be there?
Oh.
No.
Oh. Should have stayed with this one.
Well, crocodile tears up there under the big one.
Oh, Julie.
Well, Julie didn't
trust
him.
Our birthdays are the same day.
That's right. Holy mackerel. Julie, you picked up a little money here. You're up to $11,300. You're still the champion. Going to meet now Michelle Chuba. Okay. Hello, Michelle.
Hi.
How are you?
Just fine.
Good.
Fine.
Let's hear the Michelle Chuba story.
Okay. I'm a student at Chapman College studying music.
Yeah. What college is that?
Chapman College in Orange.
Chapman.
Yep. In Orange, California. I'm also working full-time selling men's clothing.
Yeah?
And in my spare time, I teach the polka.
You teach the polka?
Yeah. I'm Polish. So.
Yeah. Now, when you study music, are you a vocalist or
no,
are you
instrumentalist?
And what is your instrument?
Clarinet and piano.
That's so an interesting combination. A woodwind and a and a string percussion instrument. Yes. Well, good luck to you.
Thank
we
you.
Can't start at this moment because we have to do a little business with America. Listen to this, dear friends. Here we go. Are you ready? I push a button with my magic finger. Reveal the first round questions. Michelle, you may have A or B.
Okay, A, please.
A it is. Poor Tom. Oh. Oh, he is so competitive that when Tom's best friend swallowed a goldfish, Tom tried to swallow a blank. When Tom's best friend swallowed a goldfish, Tom tried to swallow a blank.
I'm finished.
Okay.
Can I say that?
Yes, of course. Amy.
Oh, go ahead, take it.
I know. That's right.
Okay.
It was amazing. Everybody else writing. Can I say
okay. Now we come to Michelle. Poor Tom, Michelle. He is so competitive. When his best friend swallowed a goldfish, Tom tried to swallow a blank.
A whale?
A whale. That's as far removed from a goldfish as you can get.
Oh, yeah, that's a bit too competitive.
It is,
yes. I figured maybe he tried to do his friend one better and swallow a goldfish bowl.
A goldfish bowl. That would be difficult. Yes.
I didn't know goldfish did bowl.
They don't bowl.
What's their average?
I don't know. 147.
Better than your laugh meter.
Don't get testy.
This may come as a very big shock to you, but
I'm sure it will.
My son Adam is extremely competitive, and when his brother swallows a goldfish, he goes after a whale.
One for Michelle. Well, you would know. All
well,
right.
A big mouth for a big answer. I just said a simple tuna fish.
Tuna. What's that on rye, Charles? Just plain tuna. To go, Susan. When Tom's best friend swallowed a goldfish, Tom tried to swallow a...
Trout.
A trout. That's difficult. But it was there, and he said, why not?
It's a modern thought. It's
yes,
trout.
A trout.
No, I thought he tried to swallow a shark.
Oh, that one hurt.
Well, work his way up to a whale.
Oh, I see.
Yeah,
yes.
I find that hard.
Sharks are reasonable. Whales are impossible.
Thank you.
Because being a purist at heart, a whale is a mammal, you see, and a shark is a fish.
Aha, of course, naturally. So you pick up one in round one, and that's the difficult round. Julie, here's your round wonder. The lawyer said, to Dumb Dora the secretary. Lawyer said, Dumb Dora the secretary, you idiot, I told you to type my briefs, not blank them.
I must say, there have been a lot of...
Of course, you've seen Susan Sullivan on Rich Man, Poor Man. She plays legal counsel on that show, and you see she thought of an answer immediately. Because you get involved
with
all
the... I know what I do with my briefs.
All right, here we go. Julie Yeager. Oh,
yes.
The lawyer said to Dumb Dora, the secretary, you idiot, I told you to type my briefs, not blank them.
Wash them.
Not wash them, okay? Told you to type my briefs, not wash them. What do you say?
He said, you idiot, I told you to type my briefs, not tighten them.
Oh, that's a little play of misunderstanding on words there. That's very interesting. Yes.
Okay. Launder.
Launder.
Oh, how long it took them to get that thing in about 30 seconds.
I chose starch.
Starch. I told you to type my briefs, not wash them or launder them would be a match. What do you say?
I sent starch to him.
You said starch? Well, really?
Absolutely amazing. Because I also said starch.
You said that too?
I can barely talk.
What is going on here?
But if she starched them, he wouldn't be able to stand it. No, he wouldn't be able to sit it. Is what I mean.
Oh, another one. Now, here we go to round two. Michelle.
A very stiff question.
A again, please.
You want A again?
A again, yes.
Now, let's see. One person does not play. That's Brett. Miss Smart. Horrible Hannah is so horrible.
How horrible is she?
You're fired. She had to register her blank as a lethal weapon. Horrible Hannah is so horrible, she had to register her blank as a lethal weapon.
You.
Right. Okay. Are you ready, Michelle? Horrible Hannah is so horrible. She had to register her blank as a lethal weapon.
Body? Body?
You really didn't get the handle
on
that one, did you? Well, we'll find out what happens. Scoey, she said body.
I said breath. No, I said face.
Face is probably the definitive answer. Charles?
I said also face.
That's the definitive answer there, Michelle. Face it is. What do you say?
I don't have a definitive answer. I said mouth.
Mouth. Okay, that's interesting.
Put your mouth in the faces.
Put your mouth in the faces. Now, you got to match Betty to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
Face.
So that means Julie wins another game. Michelle, it was a pleasure to meet you.
It was
a very short trip
to
you here. Oh, but we've got lots of gifts. They'll be coming to your way for the next 50 or 60 years. Who knows? Goodbye, Michelle. Oh, wow. Are you ready for this again?
I'm ready.
Well, I don't think we got time to do the whole thing now, but we want to do a little business with America. Don't go away, though. Come like that. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Should we do another chorus? You know, during the course of the week, we had a question that referred to a marvelous Harold Arlen song, was it?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Birth of the Blues.
The Birth of the Blues. And they sang their answers. And I must say, we have some very good voices here.
It brought tears to people's
That's
eyes.
That's right.
Yes.
Yes.
Especially Harold Arlen. Yes.
Now, don't forget to watch Susan Sullivan on Rich Man, Poor Man.
Yes.
She plays a lawyer there. What are you doing these days?
I'm trying to get out of here. I got a date, man.
Don't forget to watch Betty, what's her name here, on the Mary Tyler Moore Show.
And her very own show.
Well,
that's a pilot.
That's a pilot. And
now, I know we have a minute to kill, but I won't say anything because when we finally kill this minute, I won't have anything to do with it.
You do.
Tell us who'll be here the next time.
Oh, next time we get together, some of them will be here and some will not be here. Watch.
Uh-oh.
Leslie Nielsen, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Barbara Rose, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Dulavant.
Gene Everdeer, join us next week for Match Game 77. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.